Let's go to our Olympics desk in London. ABC's Bill Weir for this morning's Olympic headlines. Good morning, Bill.
Good morning to you, Robin. Josh, great to be with you from London. You know, Missy Franklin, of course, went to Aurora High School there in Colorado. She was training in France when she got the news, devastating news of the shooting. Had to wait hours. She saw it on Twitter, had to wait hours to confirm that none of her friends or family were hurt there. And then coming to the game, she vowed to try to give Colorado a reason to be proud, take their mind off the pain for a bit. And last night, in that 100-meter backstroke, did she ever.
Girls who ignore advice to join famous coaches in Florida or California. Girls who turn their back on agents and cash because they'd rather go to college. But Missy Franklin swims pure. Even more amazing, that win was her second race in 15 minutes. But that's the grind when you set out to win an unprecedented 7 medals. No wonder they call her the female Michael Phelps, able to compete in almost every stroke thanks to a powerful 6'1" frame. She propels herself through the water with size 13 feet and a 6'4" wingspan. And with 8.5 inches from longest fingertip to wrist, she has hands the size of frisbees.
I know that I have my family and my friends and my coach behind me no matter what.
But on the men's side, more disappointment for the great wet hope. Ryan Lochte was once again destroyed by Frenchman Yannick Agnel down the stretch, finishing 4th in the 200-meter freestyle.
Michael Phelps has 2 cracks at gold. Missy Franklin also back in the 200-meter free tonight. Meanwhile, China's version of Missy Franklin is a 16-year-old named Yi Shi Wen. She has been so good, so scary fast, that the American head of the World Swim Coaches Association created a diplomatic earthquake by voicing suspicion that the Chinese are cheating, using either performance-enhancing drugs or even genetic manipulation. After Yi's split times in the medley were faster than the best men in the world, she did test negative for any drugs and said, quote, "The Chinese people have clean hands." Meanwhile, a stunner in the gym, Team USA, was a lock to win the gold, it seemed, but they just had an epic fail yesterday, staggering their way into 5th place as China took the gold. But in that same event, Princes William and Harry had plenty of reason to yell huzzah as their male gymnasts earned their first medal in 100 years. They thought they had the silver until the successful Japanese protest pushed them down into the bronze. But even though the University of Florida now has more overall medals than the United Kingdom, there is so much infectious enthusiasm among our allies on this side of the pond. When Americans aren't cheering for Team USA, Robin, Josh, they're cheering for Team GB.
As well they should be. And Bill, of course, the globe really connecting with itself via Twitter, the social media, really taking over these Olympics as well. We'll be checking back in with you in just moments. But take a look at what Ryan Lochte had to say after his most recent heartbreak. "The greatest athletes suffer the hardest defeats before the biggest and best moments of your life. God has a plan for everyone." And again, Lochte will have a few more shots at medals. So let's take a look at our updated medal counts. And again, no surprises here. You do see the Korean Peninsula represented, both south and north. But these are the big favorites. We mentioned Japan there in the men's team events there with gymnastics. So now Japan moving past Italy into 3rd. China and the U.S. still with 17 medals each. China leading the way with 9 golds. Robin?
But so many appreciate, Josh, what Ryan Lochte had to say in that tweet.